Welcome to NYNJPA Weather, your severe weather source for the Northern Mid-Atlantic. I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. Good morning. It's Wednesday, August 10th. We're halfway through the week and heading towards the weekend. So what can we expect for today? Well, our cold front that produced very heavy rainfall over the New York City metropolitan area, some locations anywhere from 1 to 3 inches of rain, especially from Connecticut to northeast New Jersey, and also produced an isolated potential tornado and strong wind gusts over southern New Jersey, is now well out into the Atlantic back here, but we still have a few more weak cold fronts to move through. But clearly you can tell that skies are clearing over much of the New York City and Philadelphia metropolitan area, with only a few high to mid-level clouds approaching from central Pennsylvania and eastern Pennsylvania. But for the most part, I think today's going to be a rather pleasant day, aside from the higher levels of humidity compared to what we'll see over the next few days. So let's take a look at the latest surface map. And this is, of course, from the Severe Prediction Center, the excellent source of data for surface observations. And as you can see here, we have humidity falling off slowly but surely over the northern mid-Atlantic. First area of cold front, the first cold front that moved through yesterday, had dew points in the 70s. The second cold front that is starting to move through now has dew points anywhere from the mid to upper 60s. And behind that cold front, we are in the lower to mid 60s. And the final cold front way back here is upper 50s to lower 60s and mid 50s. So as you can see, dry air is moving in, but we're going to have to basically step down to a much drier air mass. So for today, because of these various cold fronts, we're going to have to deal with the potential for some severe thunderstorms. Now, the mid-level dynamics this time, unlike yesterday, are somewhat favorable for the development of isolated severe thunderstorms. But this time as well, let me pull up 500 millibars. The jet streak associated with these cold fronts are focused more over the Great Lakes and off towards New England. We have a weak jet streak over parts of New Jersey that is with the old cold front that is exiting. And really the best potential for thunderstorm development looks to be over central and southwestern New York and off towards the central Hudson River Valley and New England. As far as the northern Mid-Atlantic, I think your best potential is from northeastern Pennsylvania through northern Jersey and parts of the New York City metropolitan area. Now, this will be an isolated threat. And the reason why is because at the surface, even though we're humid, our dew points are falling because drier air is moving in. And also, we're starting to develop subsidence from the stronger lifting over portions of New England. So as a result, I think that the Philadelphia metropolitan area remains dry. I think much of central and southern New Jersey remains dry today. And then a few isolated thunderstorms will develop with the support of low-level instability, which will start to build this afternoon and then rapidly decline this evening. So look for a thunderstorm threat for today from about 2 p.m. until roughly 7, 8 p.m. over these locations. And then once the sun sets and the temperatures really start to fall off, much like yesterday, the thunderstorm threat will just rapidly decrease and no longer be a threat. So if you're going to the Mets or Yankees game this evening, there is a potential for a brief delay to the start of both of these games. But then after 8 p.m., you're in the clear and sit back and enjoy two very fun teams. The Yankees, who are likely going to be in the playoffs, and the Mets, who will probably drag everyone else out of the playoffs in the National League because that team does not know how to quit, even though they won't make the playoffs this year. I just want to drop down to the tropics here, and I want to point out a very interesting disturbance. Now, the National Hurricane Center has this whole area highlighted as if it's one disturbance, but I submit to you we really have two disturbances here. We have a low-level circulation with this area of thunderstorms, And we have another low-level circulation with this cluster of thunderstorms. When we put it into motion, let's fix this here. You could see there are two distinct areas of circulation here. Now, with this being the case, there are two potential outcomes here, well, actually three. The first outcome is that one of these circulations collapses and the other one becomes the more dominant low-level circulation and becomes a tropical depression. Scenario number two is one of them races off to the northwest and develops, and the other one moves to the west and also develops into two separate tropical systems. And then the third one is that, well, both of these circulations cancel each other out and nothing develops. So we're going to have to sit back and watch this. But this is the type of potential I've been discussing about the Cape Verde season, because we have just disturbance after disturbance after disturbance moving off of the African coast. They all exhibit mid to low level circulations, strong areas of convection or thunderstorms. So it's really a matter of time till the tropical Atlantic really starts to get active and very, very busy. So it looks like these disturbances right here are definitely something to watch. I would not be surprised if we start to see a better potential for a tropical depression probably this weekend. I think it's going to take a little bit longer than 48 hours for this to develop. But this weekend, we should see either one or two new tropical depressions to keep an eye on for next week. Off to the model guidance. This is from the Penn State EWOL website, and this is of course the GFS model guidance. Now first, let me go to the European model guidance. I just wanted to show that really we're dealing with the model guidance overall is handling this pattern pretty respectfully. And now there is some concern that some of the PVA, or basically upper level lifting associated with this pattern, is being a little bit over enhanced due to convective feedback. For example, look at these circles here. I have a hard time believing that we're going to see three different disturbances like this in one trough. This is a textbook example of convective feedback, so I'm not really putting a lot of weight into this idea. But the point that we're starting to see here is that our ridge, heat ridge, is starting to break down. And our ridge over the Western Atlantic remains rather strong. And we have lower heights over parts of southeastern Canada and the Northern Atlantic, supporting a negative NAO, negative Arctic oscillation pattern, which means that cold fronts are going to be readily moving through the Northern Mid-Atlantic, which is why we have a weakness along the East Coast. Now back to the GFS model guidance. You can see for today, we're going to have an isolated shot for thunderstorms this afternoon and evening. Again, I do not expect this to be a big deal. I think your best potential really is going to be over Western Connecticut, where the Western Connecticut is going to be closest to the strongest dynamics, as you can see right here. But I think a lot of your thunderstorm potential is going to be up around New England. Moving forward through the rest of this week, high pressure is going to be in control all the way until Saturday. By Sunday, we have a cold front moving through. Again, I think this is a little bit overdone, but clearly we'll be dealing with showers and thunderstorms on Sunday. This is a clear example of convective feedback right here. You see this bullseye? So I'm not buying that very much. This is a clear example of convective feedback. But I do expect scattered showers and thunderstorms. Not a complete washout, but clearly Saturday is the best day of the weekend. And then after that, high pressure takes hold once again, and I expect clearing skies for Monday and Tuesday. This is going to be an excellent day with temperatures in the upper 70s to mid 80s, low humidity, a perfect day on Tuesday. In fact, really, from tonight on through Saturday, excellent weather conditions, and for Sunday, sure, there's a few scattered showers, but still not uncomfortable at all. Might have to stay indoors for an hour or so because of a thunder shower. And then on Monday and Tuesday, excellent weather conditions again. So yes, we are in an active weather pattern, but clearly a cooler one and more comfortable one to be outdoors. Thank you for trusting in NYNJPA Weather as your severe weather source for the Northern Mid-Atlantic. To find the latest weather information and severe weather coverage, always trust in NYNJPAweather.com or find NYNJPA Weather on Twitter, Facebook, and Tumblr. I'm your meteorologist, Stephen DiMartino. Have an excellent day.